Hi, my name is Carter Razink, and I'm the CEO of DropChain. Today, we're going to show you how to freeze and unfreeze a token or an NFT using DropChain. If you haven't yet, create a free account on dropchain.network and do the Quickstart tutorial. All the links are in the description below. And using the DropChain API, like I'm going to show you here, allows you to create Web3 apps both with code or with no code. And in this example, we're gonna show you how to test this out 100% no code. Without further ado, let's jump in, right? So in this case, we're first gonna freeze a token or an NFT. What we've done before, and there's videos previously to kind of show you the whole setup, we first minted an NFT, right? We took, we go back to the developer console, which is at console.dropchain.network, 100% free to get started with. We created our app, we created an API key, and we have a bunch of test accounts. With this, we took test user one, and we minted an NFT called DropChain NFT, right? Then we took test user two, right here, AAX, AAX, and we opted it in to receiving this asset, this NFT we just made. We have this in place as a spam prevention measure. Then we also have asset send, which allows test user one to send the NFT to test user two. And so right now we're gonna show you how to freeze the NFT from in test user two's account. And so the thought process is, imagine you want to create a Web3 game or a Web3 ticketing platform, and you want to give out NFT tickets or NFT assets, and you don't want these NFT tickets, in this case of a ticketing platform, to change or leave from the person you gave that to. And so a good example of this would be, to prevent scalping, right? Maybe you don't want people to sell NFTs on the secondary marketplace because you want these to be locked to a person until the event occurs, so you don't have a bunch of people buying these assets and try to run up the price. Or in the example of a Web3 game, maybe you want them to stick to the player and it's sort of like their game identifier, right? You level up your player, the NFT continues to upgrade and change, which you can actually create metadata with, which we're gonna show you after this video, a couple of videos down the line, how to create NFTs with metadata and how to attach those to these NFTs and all that fun stuff, right? Whatever it is, you have the ability to freeze NFTs or tokens. And so we're gonna create that request right now. Go to postman.com and create your free account. As we've done here, we created a collection and then we've created these three requests. And so we're gonna make a fourth. We're gonna hit the three bullet points or dots on the side. We're gonna add add request. So notice how it says post request. We're gonna make sure that says post right here. We're gonna copy the URL, which is our api.dropchain.network, and then B1 freeze asset testnet, because that's exactly what we're doing. And within the authorization section, we're gonna hit API key and add the key as the header API, X API key, and then your API key as the value here. So as I mentioned before, when you generate your API key for the first time, it's going to show exactly as you see here. With obviously, it's going to be different for your API key. And then when you come back here at a later date, that's going to be censored. So save this, save it securely. And if you lose it or misplace it or expose it somehow, make sure you delete it and then generate a new one. But we're just going to add that to the header. We're also going to add the header of content type here. And then it's going to be application JSON right there. And we're going to actually do exactly that. We're going to hit raw. It's going to say JSON. And we're going to hit data. And we're going to copy this data with the, between the brackets, including the brackets. We're going to paste that into the body. And so just like we had asset mints, we opted in, and then we sent it from user one to user two. We're going to fill this out. User one is going to be the person who made the NFT, which is our test user one. And we're going to be freezing the receiver user ID. The receiver is the person who has the NFT who we are freezing. Otherwise, we're going to hit app ID. We're going to go back here. We're going to grab the app ID. We'll paste it in between the quotes. And then asset ID is going to be the asset ID that we just minted, see here, that we're going to be freezing. So because it's unique, you can only really freeze one at a time because that's how you specify it. So we're going to freeze the DropChain NFT that was sent from user one, was opted in by user two, AAX, and we sent it from user one, OZD, to user two. So user two, receiver ID, user two, or test user two right here, is the current owner of this DropChain NFT that we sent to AKED. We actually go back here, AKED, this wallet address matches to this user ID. And we're gonna put that into the asset ID. And you can leave session token blank. We're gonna make sure we save the transaction, this API request. We're gonna have asset freeze. And we're gonna hit send. And what we should see is we should see that we have a sender, which is test user one, freeze the asset ID, the DropChain NFT, with test user two. Perfect. Freeze state is true. The receiver frozen address is AKED, which unsurprisingly, AKED is test user two, which matches up perfectly with what we just did. The sender address MQSK. This test user one, that's everything that makes sense. And then our transaction ID, let's take a look and see what this looks like. And so exactly like we expect, we have frozen, our type is freeze, we've frozen the DropChain NFT, and we've the user one, like sender, updated user two, and the new freeze status is true. DropChain freeze transaction, that's exactly right. And so, let's try to say, imagine we wanted to send this token, we're test user two, and we want to send this to someone else. Let's say we want to send it back to test user one. So I'm going to copy receiver user ID, and I'm just going to swap them. And so what I've done here is I've taken what was previously user one, this is test user one, receiver one, which is test user two. I'm going to copy this or cut this. I'm gonna paste it here. I'm gonna cut that, paste it here. We just swapped receiver one user ID and user one user ID. And so now what we're doing here is we're saying, let's try to take user two and send it back to someone else, user, in this case, user one. And we should see this not work, right? It's frozen, it shouldn't move, it can't move. We froze it, she can't move, exactly. So it says unexpected algo HTTP error, transaction, this ID, asset, this ID, which if we go here, that's exactly the same DropChain NFT, is frozen in AKED, which is test user two. That's exactly right. That's everything we expect. And so now we're gonna add a new request. We're gonna hit post. We're gonna do asset unfreeze. So this is the exact flip side. We're gonna take the asset, we're gonna unfreeze it. This is post, we're gonna copy this URL. Great, we're gonna make sure that we have the API key, add it to the header. We're gonna also include the content type so that we know that we're sending the right information, application, JSON, body, raw. We're gonna copy the data right here. By the way, all of this information about the guides and the how-tos here is in our documentation linked below. You can see the curl is exactly everything you need. And we're just gonna fill it out like we have been before. Oops, we're gonna paste the app ID. We're gonna hit the user ID, which unfreezing an asset requires you to be the creator of the asset, which is test user one from the first video when we made the NFT for the first time. The receiver ID is the test user two, which owns the asset. So they're the one who is getting their asset unfrozen. And then asset ID is going to be the asset ID that we minted in the first place. None of this has changed the whole time. Make sure we save. I just command S on Mac or control S on Windows, or you can hit the save button and you can tell it's saved because everything updates. Now it says post on the left here. And we hit send. And we should see the exact same thing as asset freeze, but now it's unfrozen. It says asset freeze state is false. It is not frozen. Exactly like we expect. Freeze state is false. Receiver address is still test user 2's wallet. Sender is test user 1's wallet. Transaction ID, if we go back here, is exactly what we expect, right? New freeze status update to false. We are unfreezing this. It's a freeze transaction. Everything is matching up exactly what we expect. And there you have it. And that's it. You can build a robust Web3 app using just the DropChain API and many different no-code solutions and products out there right now. The first step, click the link below or go to dropchain.network and make a free developer account to get started. And join the Discord. There's a link below. Join the community, ask questions, get involved. I'm in there, my co-founder's in there, and multiple other builders. And our DropTev community is active every day in building their own Web3 apps. You should join and be a part of it. Thanks.